Let me see the other question here. So thanks for your questions in the chat. I see more activity in the chat. I really appreciate that. And if you have any questions, just leave them in the chat and I will do my best to answer. What else do we have here? How to sync loops with the grid. So this is one of the latest features of FL Studio, which I really, really like and I appreciate that they had here. So one of the things that I really enjoy about Ableton Live is that you can drag and drop a sound, a loop, and then you can micro adjust the loop to make it stick to the grid. And in FL Studio, again, it's not the easiest thing to do. It's possible, but again, it's a little bit limited, mainly because of the workflow. You don't have the option available right inside of the tool. You have to use a plugin. So let me show you how to do that. Let's go to FL Studio. And let's say that I have here a loop. Let's use one of the loops in FL Studio. Let me actually put this at 92, something like that. I think they had here some. Okay, this one here. Let's go with this one. So I can load this loop here, and you see it already has some markers. Okay, sounds good. So what we can do here now is we can right click here in the loop. And it says, edit in audio editor. This is helpful if you want to extract just a single sound. So you can right click and open it here in audio editor. And now we have this edit in time warper. So let's click here. And this one opens up Newtone. So what we can do here, it's very, very cool. And as you can see here, some of the notes or some of the let me just open this a little bit so that we can see it a little bit better. Okay, so let's zoom in here in one of these notes. This is a snare. So let me see if I can. Yeah. So this is a snare, but you can see in the same grid here that we have in the playlist, we have this lines, these black lines, and these are the grids. So if I change this to step mode, you can see that we have some grids here that align, tells us that we are in the grid, and this is the smaller steps. The same thing happens here in Newtone. You can see that if I make this shorter, we see that it's a little bit off time. It's not ending on the 4 here. What we can do is we can adjust this here, some of these notes. I don't know if this will, let me see, how can we do this? I don't know if I can select everything. Okay, you can select everything and then just make it, for instance, at 3 bars, but I want 4. So now if I play, this should be more in time. Actually, this has to be 5. Okay, something like this, so that it stays in the grid. So if I go now and, if I look here, you see that the 2 now starts in the correct position. And these ones are all in the right position here. So if you have a loop, you can see actually this is not in the right position. It goes a little bit afterwards. So what we can do is just click on this line here and then just put it in the place. You see, and we can go through every single part of the loop and we can move it. We can actually put it a little bit further. Let's put it there and let's listen to the beat. Okay, let me put it in. Why this is 60? I don't know. I don't get it. This should be aligned with the tempo. Yes. Okay, I think I know why, because this should be 3. Let's see here now. Okay, that's it. Let's make a loop. You see this one here, we moved it from here. And let's move this one here, and let's move the last snare also here. You see the difference, and now let's bring this to the playlist and let's see the difference. You see now that the snares that I moved to the next step, now they showed here. And you can pretty much do the manipulation here in a new time. But again, it's a plugin that you have to use. It's not something that you can just go here in the playlist and change. You can do time manipulation. We can just align everything here. We have to do it in new time. And it's a really cool feature. I really appreciate the fact that FL Studio took the time to add this to the plugin set. But again, it's something that it's an extra thing. Okay, so take some time. You can also watch some image line tutorials. They have some really cool tutorials about Newtone whenever they launched the latest version. And it's a really cool thing to watch.